Tuesday night, I walked up to the house. The trees were coated in a thin layer of cold, watery sludge. The house was lit up yellow with porch lights. The sky was lit up with an orange moon. On the front steps was a dead slug. Slime that it made when it was alive. It was a trail leading right up to it. There are three trees in front of the house, and the windows are all covered up. It sits down in a shallow gorge, the earth sinking under it like folds in a pillow. On bright nights, if you look at it right, you can almost see orange moonlight trickling down the sidewalk, filling the holes in the siding and dripping from the roof. Whenever I come down here, it gets all stuck in the soles of my shoes. On Tuesday night, I took sticky footsteps up the stairs, past the slug's body, through the first screen door. The hallway is inside, but still cold. Inside, the wind still blows through. One day, when I was little, three boys cornered me against a tree and dared me to eat ants. I felt the tree sap dripping into my hands and my hair, felt the dirt smeared on my face. The boys were so tall, they covered up the whole stack. So tall, I felt like almost nothing. Sweat dripped down my cheeks, cutting paths through the dust. I scratched my fingernails over the bark of the tree, skewered the ants, stuck them straight into my mouth, and swallowed. I was a bug cannibal. The boys laughed and walked away. I didn't say anything. I was a cannibal like them. On Tuesday night, I stood still in the creaking hallway. Underneath the faint buzzing lights, I felt my skin getting slimy and my heart beating fast. I could smell something rotting under the floorboards. My feet were stuck to the floor. A slug doesn't have a heart. Instead, its body is filled with tiny muscles and viscous skin. When it stops moving, its slime hardens and adheres up to the surface it's on. This is why slugs can hang or move on surfaces that are upside down. I slid my feet along the floor until I came to a rickety balcony, swaying in the night air. Breathing hard, I held onto the railing with both hands. Against the tree, feeling ants swarming under my tongue, I stared up at the faraway moon. Stared past the porch lights, the sloping carpet of the gorge, past the sticky leaves and the dirty fingernails, and the thread holding everything together, all the way down the hall, all the way to the courts to bomb the staircase. I don't usually think about the slime trail I'll die in someday. I don't think about where I came from. I don't think about where I'm going. I don't think about the squish of my muscles slowing down. I think about how, on the front steps, there was a dead slug. It was surrounded by the slime that I made when it was alive. There was a trail leading right up to it.